buy online, so this makes it a wider place to buy it. And to the designer, it can be of all ages as long as you provide me with potential for growth. If I know that you can grow, then the designer will be welcomed into my business. So my customer archetypes are between 15 and 25-year-old women of the middle and the upper middle class, and who appreciate different kinds of clothes of high quality material. And my other customer is the new designers who have different kinds of designs and is something that will provide a good growth opportunity. My market size, I made a few assumptions that the same proportion of women in Bangalore will be in the middle and the upper middle classes. So once I do that and take just 1% of this, I have about 13,040 women who can buy my product. And then for the designers, there are approximately 20 Bangalore-based designers who have made it big in the international arena. So there is a place for them, and there is the potential in Bangalore. My competitor analysis. I want to focus on how my business is different from my competitors. As you can see, each of them have they're focused on one thing. Like the Soul Sante is focused on new designers, and Zara has sort of the same design, but they're for aimed at price conscious people. And ASOS is for people who are not extremely price conscious. And so my company sort of combined all of it so that I wanted for price conscious people with good design and have interesting design elements. My competitive advantage is that I focus on small designers who have interesting ideas and clothes that are different. And since I have multiple designers, I will essentially have a bigger market share. And they're all aimed at the same target market, so they can capture more attention. And also having different kinds of designs means that there are more chances to change the trend and the stores will eventually expand to different cities and hopefully into the international arena. In my SWOT analysis, I want to focus mostly on the opportunities because there's a huge supply of young designers, and since the fashion trends are changing, there's always like this potential to have more people in the fashion industry. And since it's a developing country, since the population is growing in India, that my target market is constantly increasing. And the incomes are also rising in India, so more people are willing and able to pay for my products. And also my strengths are, since I am in the fashion industry, I do have contacts, and they will be able to help me throughout this process. In my product development, the designers will be filling out a form, which I will show you. And the designers who offer great potential are selected. So this is a sort of example of the kind of form. So you have the name, age, and like, just through this and a few examples of their design, you can sort of see where it goes. And again, since I'm in the industry, I do know how you can further work it if people would actually be interested. And then the designers are promoted and they're given finance, the business models are made for them, and they're completely set up to sell their products. So by doing this, you give them the creative independence to focus on just their work. And this is an example of my website, and I'll have the different kinds of designers, and it'll be a link to each of their websites.
One minute.
Okay, in my marketing mix, I've already explained my product to you, and my promotion is going to be on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, where they can put up pictures, they can comment about it, and upload pictures in their websites or on these pages. And customers can vote for their favorite outfits and feature that designer. And I have model friends who can talk about the store, and there's a word of mouth promotion as well. And a fashion show will be taking place during the opening and in the third year. And I'll have sponsorship and people in the industry talk about the designer and the potential they see there. And there'll be an online store, and the products are sent like You see that the cost increase in year one and year three, because these are the times of growth, and this is where you focus on the growth, and there are high initial costs, and my fixed costs are very high because there's the administrative costs and paying for everything, just getting it all set. And then in the third year, there's expansion, and that's why there is a higher cost. And my key assumptions for this are there are low revenues in Feb and March and in these months, because there are usually exams during this time, and then it starts becoming summer and special festivals in India. And then my net profit and all of that per unit. And this is my sales, my team, and I've selected these people specifically because she has expertise in the marketing field. He's good at math, she's my designer. And these two are actually models, so I think they'd be useful to have in the store because people would be interested in coming to the store to meet them as well. And what's next? Well, buying my domain name is important. And then I will have an internship with a modeling company, so I will interact with designers and learn about what they like, what they dislike, how they work. And I will register the company and then identify the designer and do more market research to understand the market and make changes.
Excellent.